Hi friends, how are you? This is Chikri and welcome to our channel Chikri's Garden. Friends, today I am going to show you one more beautiful and super rare plant from my succulents collection. Name of this plant is Dicaria madagascariensis. This is also called as zigzag plant and it origins from southern Madagascar in Africa. And it belongs to the family Didaraceae. This deciduous spiny shrub or tree is the only species in the genus that has succulent stems growing in a zigzag pattern with two spines on the outside where the stem changes direction and it grows approximately up to 20 to 30 feet in tall. This is a super rare succulent with a trunk that has fronds all over and will grow tiny leaves when mature. New stems will later sprout from the underneath and as the time goes by, they spread to form a stunning structure. This is one of my most favorite plants that I have in my collection. It looks so beautiful with its zigzag pattern and looks like a decorative, ornamental and artificial plant. These plants can grow well in full sun and also can be grown as an indoor plant and also in semi-shade areas. These plants when grown in outdoors can be watered frequently, but the indoor growing plant should be taken care while watering like other succulents. This plant also doesn't like to hold more water near its roots and will be easily rotten. So we need to see that the media should be completely dried before watering again. Coming to the potting media, we can use any of the cactus and succulents potting media and we should see that the pot has good drainage holes. I prefer to use cinder mix for most of my plants and especially for the plants from Africa so that they can look and grow like in their natural habitat. I keep my plants in poly house and will water them 2 to 3 times in summer and in other months only once a week or 10 days depending upon the climatic and temperature conditions. This plant also produces beautiful blooms and at that time the beauty of this plant will be doubled than in normal days. These plants can easily be propagated through cuttings rather than growing from seeds. The germination percentage will be very low if we want to grow them from seeds. So it is most widely propagated through cuttings only. Okay friends, I hope you liked this video. If you do so, please give us a like. Also subscribe to our channel if you didn't subscribe yet. Please click the bell icon to get my regular updates. Okay friends, I'll see you in my next videos. Until then, take care. Bye-bye.